Now to a Contact 17 News investigation. A viewer brought a dangerous situation in Wasco to our attention. He says something needs to be done before someone ends up dead. 17's Madeline Jansen is joining us live from Wasco tonight with this Contact 17 investigation. Madeline?
Robin, as you can probably hear, we're right by the rail yard here. And while we've been posted up here for the last few hours, we've seen several kids scramble across these railroad tracks in between the rail cars. And that is exactly what's concerning many Wasco residents. This freight train barreling by was enough to keep our 17 News crew behind the yellow line. But it apparently doesn't frighten the kids in this neighborhood.
Underneath and through, and they jump over the couplings between cars. I've seen them literally dive underneath a car and scramble across.
They try to beat the train, you know, and they get close. I mean, it's very dangerous, but they won't go around because the people from the end of the camp, they ain't gonna walk all the way over here.
Even though the actual street crossing is just a block or two further, kids are finding this hole in the fence and this shortcut through the train yard to be much more convenient.
But it's a tragedy waiting to happen.
Somebody should do something, like maybe the city.
Frustrated with nothing being done to stop the students, Tom France took this video and emailed it to 17 News and the city of Wasco.
As far as I'm aware, no, this is really the first time it's been brought to as a concern before the city.
Wasco City Manager Jim Zervis says his staff will be meeting with the Kern County Sheriff's Department and the Housing Authority on Tuesday to see what can be done about this problem. We also took the issue to BNSF, who owns one of the tracks in the yard. They say what the kids are doing is not only dangerous, it's illegal, and they'll have their police department patrol the area as well. Brant says he hopes the agencies follow through and put a stop to the illegal crossing before tragedy strikes. Now, coming up tonight at 6, we talked to one man today who says this problem has been going on for around 30 years. In fact, he says he used to take the shortcut when he was a kid, and he even once found himself underneath a rail car when it started to move. We'll have more on his story coming up tonight at 6.
A danger for kids, it's all caught on tape. We get a call to the Eyewitness News tip line about children crossing train tracks in Wasco. Our reporter Carol Ferguson shows us now what's happening. Carol.
Well, we went looking for answers. I went to see this for myself, and we went to city officials. Here's a good look at the problem. A kid crosses just as a train roars up near the Amtrak station. Amateur video shot earlier this week.
Oh, I'm just standing right here.
By retired teacher Tom France. He's worried. In just 15 minutes, we saw two freighters. He sees a lot of kids walking across the tracks.
But it's extremely dangerous. Kids have earphones in their ears. They're not even going to hear a sudden movement in the train.
Even the parked cars can move suddenly. It's all dangerous.
There's a lot of houses all the way through here.
Kids cross to get to school or town.
Yes, every day.
Nancy Zuniga lives in the housing behind the tracks, and she worries.
It's shorter for them to go round through the fence.
The concern is that kids are coming from here, a good-sized housing area, and instead of going down there to where the street is and the real crossing, they get onto the tracks through this, holes in the fence. France took his video to Wasco City Hall.
Said it's really not their property, it's really not their business directly.
Those fences aren't owned or maintained by the city.
I also went to city manager Jim Zervis. What can they do? He told me they'll meet with the managers of the housing area, try to educate kids and families. And they'll contact the railroad.
Very secure fencing, daily patrols to make sure the fencing is in place.
Franz wants action. The neighbor says they need it now.
A couple of times we've seen close calls.
Now, I contacted the railroad about this. Spokeswoman Lena Kent tells me they will send out railroad police to the area and they'll write tickets. It's illegal to cross the tracks like that. It's trespassing. And the railroad will try to work with the schools in the area to have some safety presentations. Back to you. Thanks, Carol.
For years now, Wasco residents have been crossing the train tracks illegally, but now the city is trying to put a stop to it. 23 ABC's North County reporter Camilla Bastidas talked to residents who want to keep on crossing despite the danger. Camilla.
There are two holes that have been cut into the fences near the Wasco labor camp, and every day kids and adults use them to get across town. But concerned residents say this is an accident waiting to happen.
It's a daily routine. Everybody from here crosses here.
23 ABC drove out to 7th and G Street in Wasco just after 7 o'clock this morning. In a matter of minutes, teens and even this young child were caught on camera crossing the tracks illegally. A Wasco resident says these kids could lose their life.
The kids aren't thinking. They're wearing earphones, things like that. They're playing around. It's a tragedy waiting to happen. Might not happen for 3 years.
Some people have been crossing the tracks for years, almost on a daily basis. And they say there is no way they can get hurt.
People that live across town can hear them. What makes you think you're not going to be able to hear when you're, like, right there? Just because you have an iPod on it doesn't make a difference. You can still hear it. Or you'll feel the vibration moving.
Trains in this area roar by day and night. And despite the no trespassing signs posted through the area, people from the Wasco labor camp ignore the danger.
I don't have a car, so I have to walk all the time. I ain't going to walk all around. Just to get to the 99 sensor is going to take me forever, when I can just go through there and it'll take me it'll take me less than a minute to get across.
This is the exact mindset that the city of Wasco is trying to change.
We're going to do some educational work to try to talk to them about the safety concerns of crossing unauthorized areas, and to try to let them know ahead of time that we are going to be writing citations and where safe crossings are at.
Now, the city sent out a letter today notifying businesses that they are responsible for keeping the fences secure. And the railroad company says they are planning on doing a safety presentation at the schools to raise awareness about not crossing the train tracks. In studio, Camila Bastidas, 23 ABC.